Welcome back, everyone. Phil Jackson has coached the Chicago Bulls to 5 NBA titles over the last 7 years. He will go for his 6th this season, but that will probably be it. Peter Vesey talked with the Bulls coach.
So much fun this time. We're going to do it again next year?
Oh, man. I don't know. 3 times is nice.
The day of the draft, actually, Jerry Reinsdorf came to my office and said, you know, at this time, we're staying with Scottie Pippen in the way we've gone the last couple of years. And I knew, you know, particularly that time they'd made the decision to continue on in the championship course that we've been on for the last few years.
I heard that when things got really crazy at the end of last year,
you got on your motorcycle,
yep,
by yourself,
right,
and you went to Montana. How many days did that take you, and what were you thinking on that trip?
Well, you know, I did. I took a 5-day, 2,000-mile trip, you know. It averages out to 400 a day, but the first day I only did about 200 miles. And I was prepared to make the next move, you know, if things, you know, didn't go the other direction. If what I felt was right didn't get met. And so when I got to Montana, my final destination, and sat the bike in the garage and, you know, started to enjoy my vacation, I felt very much at peace and very much comfortable with what I knew was going to come up. And we actually, even though it would seem protracted, our negotiation, I think the negotiation actually went very well.
But up until then, you were
up
a little
until
shaky?
Then, well, I didn't care one way or the other. If they made a decision that they had to go another direction, that was their business.
What stopped Jerry Reinsdorf from trading Scottie Pippen? It was very, very close with the Celtics.
Well, I think the whole city of Chicago probably would have come to, you know, really a harsh wake-up of, you know, something that they hold very dear to them going. It had to be some kind of a blow that would be a knockout blow. I mean, they felt that if they could do in one fell swoop maybe a 3-player plus a draft situation in the future. I'm not particularly a believer in that because I think too many young players together can be a problem.
But Jerry Reinsdorf had to know that public opinion was going to be against him before he ever went as far as he did.
Well, I think so, and I think that you know, he's willing to go against public opinion. If that knockout punch would have been good enough to give them the players that they wanted, I think they would have gone for it.
Good evening, and welcome to the 1997 NBA Draft.
I was in the building. I was at my job every day. There were times when Jerry came in and said, you know, we've got to go ahead as an organization. We have to look at things that would include not having you here in case we change personnel on this team. This is a day in which you're not particularly needed, you know, here at work. If you want to take the day off, great.
Well, when he would bring in a player to look at?
I didn't know anything about players. I heard later, right, that he brought players in to look at, but that would have included a whole different type of a team. You know, that would have been somebody else. True, my advice might have been good. I mean, they could have probably used a guy's advice like myself or Tex Winter or other guys, but they chose to do this alone.
So your staff was not included either?
Right.
That didn't hurt at all, Phil?
No, I mean, that's a choice they make. If they want to, you know, not look at the skills or not take the advice that we have, if they're content with that, that's his business. It's their business. They own the business. I'm an employee.